What's going on, guys? It's been a couple weeks since I posted anything on the channel. A few weeks back, my father was diagnosed with pretty serious throat cancer. I want to say it's about like a stage three. So it's really taken up a lot of my time. I've been basically his main source of support, only one he can really rely on to really help him out. So that's pretty much been my main priority these last few weeks, you know, just making sure he's okay, and obviously that's weighing heavy on my mind, and you know, just kind of running through my mind just every couple of minutes through the day, because I'm obviously really worried about him. But I'm still on track with everything as far as contest prep goes. Training's been good, been great. I haven't really experienced much strength loss, maybe something like 5%. I'm down about close to 13 pounds now from where you guys originally saw. But I've been on track with everything, been on track with my calories, macros, track with training. And so far I'm feeling pretty good, well, within reason, right? As far as, you know, how I'm feeling physically. And mentally too, when as far as the diet goes. But I just wanted to keep you guys updated on what's going on. I've been on hiatus for the last couple weeks, and I'm definitely going to get back to posting on the channel and keep you guys well informed of what's going on with my 2017 contest prep season. Let's see, what else? Also, pretty much informed on what's going on with my dad, right? That's kind of something that's part of this journey that I want to share with you guys as well. Because because you go on a contest prep doesn't mean everything in your life freezes and, you know, nothing can go wrong. And I'm learning that the hard way this season, because, you know, little things here and there during previous seasons have gone wrong, but nothing like this. So, and I was actually going to just drop the prep altogether because, you know, he's my main priority. I want to be able to focus on that. But he's the one who told me not to. He actually wants to come and see my show. So now the pressure's on, right? Now I have to do really well. Now I have to actually make sure I really maximize everything. Now I'm really motivated. So I'm not gonna stop. I'm gonna absolutely kill it and make it worth him coming to see me. So I'm really motivated, you know, really hoping that he pulls through this. This is probably the scariest disease known to man that you can have, or one of them, right? It's definitely up there. But I think he'll be fine. I'm going to hope and pray that he'll be okay. That's pretty much that, guys. That's pretty much where I'm at right now. I've got some training footage I'm about to show here in a minute of me at roughly around 170 to 171-ish in the mornings, body weight, as well as a posing update that I did yesterday. So you guys are gonna see what I look like and training, and also just hitting a few of the symmetry, hitting all of the symmetry rounds and all the mandatory poses. So check it out. All right, guys. So here I'm just hitting some overhead press. Did anywhere from 3 to 4 sets, the rep range of 8 to 10, using 135. So strength hasn't taken too much of a dip. Like I said, somewhere around like 5%. As far as strength loss, front view, and actually recording this exercise has really helped me in perfecting and critiquing my form. Because prior to that, and as you guys can see, I'm not even looking at the mirror. Usually I don't look at the mirror when I do those. One side would feel like it's pressing more, and on the eccentric coming down, every single one would feel different. When you don't look at the mirror and you get a feel for it, you just develop much better technique. These are just some pull-ups. Did 3 sets of 10. No weight strapped to me, just body weight. Just trying to go for a full contraction. I do have a day where I do chin-ups with weight, though. Just 3 sets of 8 with a flat dumbbell bench press. I do notice this has taken a little bit more of a dip. I was able to get 10 to 12 in the beginning of my prep. Now I'm getting 8. I could push for 10, but I'm trying to stay, you know, shy of failure by a couple of reps, because it just
definitely helps out with my recovery. So, and obviously, recovery is really important when you're on a caloric deficit. Hit some face pulls right after this for shoulder health. I think everybody should have these in their program. It's a good staple. You probably see everybody on YouTube doing these nowadays. Really good exercise. Right here, I'm just hitting some just standing curls. Now, doing these, actually, this really surprised me when I saw the footage of this, because I'm really starting to see the details of my back come through. Mainly my upper back. You'll see in the posing update that I have at the end of this, my lower back, my hamstrings, still have a long, long, long way to go. A lot of body fat there. But definitely things like my abdominals, my obliques, I'm starting to see those. Starting to see some veins in the shoulders, veins in the lats. Typically for most guys, I would say girls too, but typically for most guys, your upper body's gonna come in first, lower body last, especially the glutes and hamstrings. Just doing, hitting a couple poses over here. Again, this isn't the posing update. This isn't the posing update. I'm just hitting a couple for the camera. I wanted to see what it looked like under this lighting. Get the back relaxed. I do think in the 10 months I've had off since my previous prep, I've put on a little bit of size. Good amount. Not a lot, but definitely significantly different from my 2015 physique. I would say it's mainly in my delts. I posted a picture on Instagram and people were commenting saying it was mainly in my delts. But I'd say mainly in my delts and my hamstrings. Those are the two areas that I prioritize, especially my hamstrings. Because you guys will see, if on a bodybuilding stage, if you don't have hamstrings, you're not going to do as well as the guys would do. And here's just my posing update. Got a front relax right there. Everything comes in from the front much, much, much faster. And this is where I can tell my hamstrings have definitely come up on my side relaxed poses, because my hamstring actually sticks out. Prior, it was almost like, as you can see, but from where it connects to the glute, it was just more straight down. Now it's actually starting to have that like curve, which kind of complements the quad sweep. Got it back relaxed. You guys can see here what I mean by the lower back. Not having a long way to go, and the hamstrings, there's not much detail. You can see a couple of lines, but not a lot. Side relaxed on this side. Obliques coming in a little bit. Chest. Again, guys, I'm about one third of the way through, so I still got a long, long, long way to go before I'm anywhere near what WNBF pro level conditioning standard is like. Double. My front lat is one of those poses where it doesn't really look that good until I'm like, much, much, much leaner. And I think it's mainly because it takes a long time for me to dial in my arms. They seem to hold body fat. I know most guys don't, but mine do. So they don't really, in the front poses, not so much in front double bicep, but things like front relaxed and front hands on hips most muscular. I definitely need to be really lean for those to show through. Side triceps not looking too bad. As you can see, I need to work on my posing, more so my posing stamina. As you can see, when somebody's constantly taking all those breaths and they look a little uncomfortable posing, it just means that they need to work on it. It's got to look poised, but at the same time, you got to look like your muscles are at full contraction. So kind of like that perfect balance between the two. Back double bicep, as you can see, a lot of detail missing from the arms, the Christmas tree, definitely the glutes and hamstrings, absolutely, definitely on the glutes, which is why I'm not showing you guys my glutes right now. Rear lat spread coming up. In this pose, you always want to sell that Christmas tree like I'm doing right there. Give them that Christmas tree, then boom, open it right up. Rear lat is probably one of my stronger poses. Going right into a side chest next. Again, the hamstrings, I could definitely tell they come up a bit. Good It's weird. My I actually like my side chest better from the left side. It feels a lot more natural. Side chest. Right into the side tricep. But I would say I like my side tricep on the right side much better because it feels more natural on this side. Again, those are things that just can be corrected with constant practice. And posing is very important. It doesn't matter how lean you get. If you can't pose, you can forget it. You're not gonna place that high. You'll take a dude who's a lot less conditioned than you, and he will out-pose you, and more than likely score higher than you. Moving out front, hands on hips, most muscular. That's actually looking a lot better than I thought it would. I think I kind of need to angle my quads outward more so to show more of the inner sweep. Moving out crab, most muscular. This is my preferred form. I don't like the other one where you're kind of hunched over and you kind of show more of the traps. This one displays just more of the overall physique because you can see the quads in that one. That's pretty much that, guys. 6 weeks in, about 12.5 pounds down.